Now, first of all, we will discuss friction. Friction is a force that opposes motion between any surface or any surfaces that are touching. Friction can work for against us. For example, putting sand on an icy sidewalk, friction increases, so you are less likely to slip. On other hand, too much friction between moving parts in a car engine can cause the parts to wear out. In simple words, friends, you can say friction is a force that opposes motion of an object. So next is factors affecting friction. So friends, friction between the surface depends on the smoothness of the surface in contact. A greater force is required to move the surfaces past each other when they are rough as compared to when they are smooth. Also, it is more difficult to move a heavier object on the ground than a lighter one where the two objects are of the same material. So next is types of friction. As friction is mainly divided into three types. First is static friction, second is sliding friction, third is rolling friction. Now first of all, we will discuss static friction. Static friction is a force that hinders the movement of an object moving along the path. When two fabrics slide over each other, this friction occurs. There's friction all around us when we walk. For instance, our feet are touched with the floor. So as you can see the picture, this is an example of static friction. Next is sliding friction. Sliding friction is also known as kinetic friction or moving friction, and defined as the force that required to keep a surface sliding along another surface. Next is rolling friction. If a body rolls, move with just a single point of its surface in contact over another body, the resistance offered is case of rolling friction. Rolling friction is generally lesser than the sliding friction, as this picture is an example of rolling friction. So now we'll discuss the advantages of friction. Friction is responsible for many types of motion. It helps us to walk on the ground. Brakes in car make use of friction to stop the car. Asteroids are burnt in the atmosphere before reaching Earth due to friction. It helps in the generation of heat when we rub our hands. Next is disadvantages of friction. Friction produces unnecessary heat, leading to the wastage of energy. The force of friction acts in the opposite direction of motion. So friction slows down the motion of moving objects. Forest fires are caused due to the friction between the tree branches. A lot of money goes into preventing friction and the usual wear and tear caused by using techniques like greasing and oiling. Next, methods to increase friction. First is roughen the surface. Treader tires of vehicles have designs and patterns with grooves on their surfaces to increase resistance with the road. This prevents skidding. The soles of shoes are also made with grooves to give a good grip on the ground. Next, we dry the surface. Sand and gravel is thrown on slippery ground during rainy season to increase friction. Use brake pads. We increase friction by using brake pads in the brake system. So next is methods to reduce friction. First method is polishing the surface. We polish rubbing surface to reduce their unevenness and make them smooth. Second is lubricants the surface. A common way to reduce friction is by applying a lubricant such as oil, water or grease on the surfaces or two surfaces. This forms a layer of lubricant between the surfaces. So friction is now between the surface and the lubricant, which is much less than between the two surfaces. Third is streamlining. When streamline the shapes of boat, ships, vehicle, airplanes, rockets to reduce the fluid drag. So thank you friends for watching the video. I hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe so that you can get more information about the channel.